Hey, hello everyone. So this video I'm going to show you how to perform matrix addition in Python. So we're just going to get input A and B, two matrices from the user. So let's get started. So let R equal to int of input of enter rows and just copy it and let just paste it. Okay, and let our C be the number of columns. Okay. So first let's input a matrix. Okay, for that we are going to use a list. Okay, we're just going to push a list inside a list. So each inner list is going to represent a column. Okay, so let A be our overall list. Okay, so we're just going to have for i in range of R. Okay, so this means this is same as writing as for I in range of 0, R. So it means the same. Okay, starting from 0 and ending in R minus 1. Okay, and here we will be having our, as I told you earlier, we're going to push a list inside a list. So here I will be having that temporary list. So the T be my temporary list. I'm going to assign it to 0. Okay, you will know the reason soon. Okay, why I'm doing assigning to 0 inside this loop. Okay, so matrix, for all of you might know, we will be using two for loops over here. J for J in range, and this is going to be C. Okay, and here we will be getting the input value from the user. So let val equal to int of input, and here we'll be using a formatting, okay, to just display the what that position, like A of 0 0, A of 0 1, the position of the matrix, ij of that matrix. So enter A of, this is how we represent it. Okay, and j. Okay, because we have I and j variables in the for loop. Okay, so let's have like this and put some space. So that's fine, I guess. So after we have got the value from the user, we need to just push the value in our local or temporary list. Okay, so it's going to be t dot append val. So this number of values inside this t list will be equal to the count of c. Okay, this, as this for loop is going to run c times. So after this inner for loop runs, we need to push this temporary list into our main list, that is our matrix A. Okay, so we are just going to come out of this and we are going to put A dot append t. That's it. So this is the reason I said you that matrix, we are just going to push a list inside another list. And the reason why I put t equal to 0 below the outer for loop and above the inner for loop is that once we have done with the first row, okay, this is the first kind of row, as I told you, we will be inputting row wise. So once we have done with the first row, during the input of value of second row, our new second row should be empty. Like, what if you are entering the first row 1, 2, 3, our list t will have 1, 2, 3 values. And during the second row, we are entering 4, 5, 6. So it will be like our second row will become 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it will have the previous values. To completely eliminate those previous values, I am just putting t equal to empty over here. Hope you would have got this idea. Oh, I am putting using t equal to empty list. Okay. So now I will just print and check whether what I have done is right. Okay. Print A. So now I will just run this code. Okay. Hope it works. Enter rows 3, enter columns 3, enter. So this is what I told you, that formatting option. So ij, we are getting ij value over here. So I'll just put 9 elements, okay, 3 cross 3 matrix. So 2 comma 3, can't see, I will just minimize it. So 2 comma 2. So as you can see here, we have like a perfect matrix structure we have got. So this is the first row, second row and third row. So if you like imagine column wise, this is going to be the first column, this one and this one will be the first column, and this one will be a second column. Like if you just restructure it that way, you will be getting the idea. You can just print it in the form of column also. You just use a for loop and you can just print A. Okay, so that's so unwanted stuff, so you just don't want to do that. So now what if, like, if we enter some, not a square matrix, okay, let it be a 3 cross 4. So it will have like 12 elements. Okay, so as you can see here, we have 3 rows and four columns. So one row number one, row number two, row number three, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4 columns. So it's working well. So now we will just do the same stuff, just copy this everything. Okay, let's just copy everything and we're just going to paste it over here for the second matrix. Okay, so let B be the empty list and let us have T equal to 0. That's not going to affect anything. T dot append, that's fine, and just put B dot append over here. So now let's just print A and B and let's check. Okay, so print A, we are having here, we will have print B. Okay, and instead of A we just put B over here. So now we'll just run. So 3, and I'll put 3, I'll put 1 1 1 1 1. I'll just minimize it. Okay, so it's going to be, okay, I put B for, okay, I'll put 2 also. Okay, so okay, so I'm getting these 2 ones because I put here 2 ones for B. Okay, so it's working fine. We are getting the equal length, so now that's fine. So now we are just going to add this. Okay, add this. So for adding also, it's just the same process again. Just go here and copy. That's the fun part about matrix. You can just, it's like a template. Okay, if you just perfectly do write a template for one matrix, you can just copy paste everything. So that's really cool about matrix. So here let's have C. Okay, T is fine for me, and so instead of val, we are going to create our value. So that val is equal to A of ij, okay, plus B of ij. Okay, so for those who don't know what is this A of ij and B of ij, I will just do a quick demo. Okay, so I will just remove everything. Okay, just I will just cut this. Okay, so I will just print A. Okay, so this is for those who don't know that A of ij, what does that two-dimensional meaning represents, two-dimensional indexing refers. First, let me put 3 cross 3, so it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So it's pretty simple. Okay, so this is going to be the first list. Okay, first inner list. Okay, so actually this, we have the outermost list, so this is the main list, and each list is an element in the main list itself. So this is the first list. Okay, first element of our main list, second element of our main list, third element of our main list. So this is going to be 0th index. This entire list will be referenced by 0, entire list referenced by 1, entire list referenced by 2. So it's A of 0 means it basically refers to our first list, A of 1 refers to our second list, A of 2 refers to our third list over here. So that's simple. So A of 0, so A of 0 of 0 means we are referring to our 1, and A of 0 of 1 we are referring to 2, and A of 0 of 2 we are referring to 3. Same process here also, A of 1 of 0 4, A of 1 of 1 5, A of 1 of 2 is 6. So same thing. So this is what we are doing with multi-indexing. Okay, so if we just paste it now, instead of this val equal to input, we are just going to put val equal to A of ij plus B of ij. So it's the same stuff. Okay, so as for matrix, you know, the elements present in the same index of A matrix will be added to the element present in the same index of B matrix. So like ij are going to be same for both A and B, so they are going to get added up. And like I have done a silly mistake over here, I have used C equal to as a list also, and I have done the same as a variable, so avoid that. Okay, I'll just rename it as sum. Okay, I thought of using ABC, but just now I got removed that I've used a column as a variable as also C, so just change it to sum, otherwise you will be getting an error. So now let's just print. Okay, print A, print B. So this is our whole matrix, and at last we'll print our sum. Okay, so we have got all the stuff. Okay, A refers to that matrix and we are printing our sum. So let's just run now. We are doing a 3 cross 3 matrix, 1 for all A's. Okay, we'll just minimize it again. Mm-hmm. 2 for all B matrix. So as you can see here, it's working perfectly, and so you can know 1 added gets added to 1 and 3 and same stuff. So now we'll do with some other values, okay? Same 3 cross 3, but I will change the value to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Just to verify, okay? You can just verify by using, not just using the same values, you can just use some sequential values, okay? So that it will be easy for you as well to compute the sum. Same values are going to go in B also. So as you can see here, 1 plus 1, I'm going to do 2 plus 2, 4, 3 plus 3, 6. 4 plus 4, 8, 5, 5, 10. So that's working perfectly. So that's it. I hope you have got this video useful, and I hope you have understood matrix addition in by using Python. So I've done also tutorials in C, C++, Java, Blender, 3D animation, and Unity. So it will be really great if you could check other videos of my channel. I've also done activity diagrams, that UML software engineering diagrams. So really great. It will be really great if you could subscribe my channel and support me, and it's really helpful. And thanks for watching.